are here today outside the offices of Positive Luxury to ask them to reconsider their outrageous decision to shortlist the Beer Forever Mark Diamonds for an award for positive environment impact. We are here to tell Positive Luxury that human beings are also part of the environment, that the litany of human rights abuses that the Beers has committed cannot be greenwashed by sponsoring a few elephants and rhinos. Shame on you, Positive Luxury, for greenwashing the Beers' human rights abuses. Shame on you, Positive Luxury, for greenwashing the Beers' human rights abuses. In the podcast interview that Positive Luxury has featured on its website as evidence of the De Beers green credentials, De Beers Forever Mark chairman, Steven Lucia, says he is overwhelmed with emotion when he sees a baby rhino with his mother and one of the De Beers mines, as it is a connection to the De Beers' historic past. But when we look at reality, it is very different. De Beers' history from its inception till today, it is a history of a serial human rights abuser committing crimes on an industrial scale. De Beers Diamond Empire was founded by the genocide white supremacist Cecil Rhodes, who with De Beers mercenary army massacred 60,000 black Africans to steal their lands of Zimbabwe and Zambia, which he then renamed after himself, Rhodesia. He built De Beers Diamond Empire on the blood of black African, indentured slave labor. He caged them in concentration camps where tens of thousands died due to lack of food, inadequate shelter, and non-existent medical care. The laws, De Beers passed to subjugate black workers later formed the foundation of apartheid in South Africa. During apartheid in South Africa, De Beers was a solid pillar of the apartheid regime. Apartheid Prime Minister John Botha described De Beers as bricks in the walls of the regime's continuous existence. Even after apartheid ended in South Africa, De Beers refused to pay any compensation to its victims, and instead used its economic might to blackmail the elected government of Nelson Mandela into making concessions to enable it to continue exploiting black Africans. Today, with its deep links to the Israeli diamond bars, De Beers helps sustain apartheid in Palestine. De Beers sells around 90% of its rough diamonds to a few selected partners known as sideholders, around 20% of these sideholder partners are part of the Israeli diamond bears. In 2014, 521 children, Palestinian children, were slaughtered by Israel whilst they took shelter in United Nations schools and in their homes. These were declared war crimes and possibly crimes against humanity by the United Nations Human Rights Council. At the time, the bears partner, the Israeli diamond bears, boasted of sending trucks, loads of military equipment to help this slaughter of the children in Palestine. Israeli economist Shir Hiva testified at the Russell Tribunal in November 2010 that overall the Israeli diamond industry contributes about $1 billion annually to the Israeli military. This is only possible with the De Beers active complicity in supplying uncut diamonds to the Israeli diamond bears. Shame on you, positive luxury, for rewarding these war crimes by bestowing the beer, bestowing the beers with the butterfly mark. Shame on you, positive luxury, shame, for rewarding these war crimes, but bestowing the beers with the butterfly mark. Shame on you, the beers. Shame on you, positive luxury.
People are left questioning what exactly the butterfly mark represents. It is just another advertising ploy used by corporations to flog their goods on unsuspecting consumers. Are the awards positive luxury bestows on corporations bought and paid for by the corporations? Positive luxury cannot claim ignorance, as they have already been alerted to the beer's dirty secrets. Rather than do something about these revelations, positive luxury has instead helped the beers to try and hide them by deleting posts on its Facebook page. In trying to greenwash the beers at Forever Monk brand, positive luxury is in danger of destroying its own brand and the butterfly mark. We urge positive luxury to do the right thing and drop the beers. Issue a statement before the awards ceremony next Tuesday that the butterfly mark has been removed from the beers and that the beers has been removed from the shortlist for the Positive Environmental Impact Award. Positive luxury, do the right thing, drop the beers.